Bam, Mr. True. In this video, we're going to continue our discussion about arithmetic sequences. And we're going to do that by talking about the nth partial sum. The sum of the first n terms of an arithmetic sequence is found with the formula S of n equals n divided by 2 times a sub 1 plus a sub n. Let's not forget that n is the number that you're plugging into this formula, or that tracks where you are in an arithmetic sequence. So when n is equal to 4, you're looking at the fourth term of the sequence. If n is equal to 5, you're looking at the fifth. A sub n is that value that you get, that actual term. So this is a sub 1 is 2, a sub 2 is equal to 11, a sub 3 is equal to 20, and that's when n equals 1, n equals 2, and n equals 3. Again, with arithmetic sequences, you recognize that by looking at your list of numbers and observing that there is a constant addition, and it can be, and you can be adding by a negative number, which will look like subtraction, but there's a constant addition. So we're going from 2 to 11, we're adding by 9. From 11 to 20, we're again adding by 9, and then adding by 9 again to get to 29, and so on. Or, you know, you could say it in like math terms, a sub n minus a sub n minus 1 is a constant difference. So back subtract to make sure you have the same difference for all of your terms in the sequence. Okay, at any rate, let's find these partial sums. Here we've got 2, 11, 20, 29, 38, and 47. And, you know, for space purposes, I didn't write out the question, but I'd like the partial sum. I'd like the sum of the first six numbers. Now, it is only six numbers, so we could simply just add this up. But this formula is to save time when we have to add, you know, 50, 60, 70, 80, 100 numbers or even more, where you would not want to just go, okay, 47 plus 38 plus 29 and so on and just manually add those up. So, S sub 6, we're going to find the sum of the first six terms in the sequence. That's what the subscript means, is equal to n, or 6, divided by 2, times a sub 1, which is, 2, plus a sub n, which is 47. Okay, well, you know, follow the order of operations. We're going to do 2 and 47, make 49, and, well, let's clean this up as well. 6 divided by 2 is equal to 3. So we have 6 divided by 2 is 3. Cleaning up inside the parentheses, we have 49. And then this partial sum is equal to, let's see here, 3 times 40 is 120, and 3 times 9 is 27. So 120 plus 27 is 147. Let's just make sure that's right. And yes, it is. Okay, moving on to our second example. Find the sum of the first 30 terms. Now, here, I'm going to extend this previous example where you don't actually know what the 30th term is. So, you can do this off to the side. I'm going to include it in the formula and show you all this work at once. We need to know what that a sub n value is. We need to know what that a sub 30 term is. So, we're going to do the sum of the first 30. That is going to be equal to n over 2, or 30 divided by 2, times again a sub 1, we know what that value is, it's equal to 2, plus a sub n, and I don't know what a sub 30 is, so either in your formula or off to the side, just go figure it out. A sub 30, now if you have forgotten, arithmetic sequence, the general form of an arithmetic sequence is not the same color. Well, I'm out of color, so it's going to have to be green to match this example. A sub n equals a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times d. So I'm going to apply this formula inside the second part of my partial sum formula and find out that a sub n value. Okay, so a sub 1 is 2 plus n minus 1, and n is equal to 30 in this example, so 30 minus 1 times my common difference of, we identified it earlier, common difference of 9. So a sub 1 plus n minus 1 times my common difference of 9. 1, 2, 3 open, and 2 open, 3 open, 2 open, 1 open. Okay, I'm missing a parenthesis. And then simplify this out. Well, we have 30 divided by 2 is 15. 2 plus, we've got 2 plus 30 minus 1 is 29, times 9. And of course, I don't want to go ahead and struggle with this and take up your time. So 29 times 9 is 261. So we have 15 times 2 plus 2 plus 61, or 2 plus 261. That's going to give us 15 times 2 plus 263. Which, of course, is just going to be 265, so I should just go ahead and write that. And then 15 times 265 is 3975, or 33,975. And that's, you know, just a couple of examples, pretty straightforward examples of how to find partial sums of an arithmetic sequence. And one a little bit harder than the other. Now, our third example is, again, going to be a partial sum, but my problem is written in summation notation. So, you know, what is that partial sum? Now, you might not look at this and immediately go, well, that's arithmetic. But multiplication is repeated addition. If I do 4 plus 4 plus 4, which is 12, well, that's just 3 times 4. So multiplication does, you know, display a sort of shorthand version of repeated addition. So this is indeed going to be arithmetic. And if you're not sure, if you need a more concrete example of that, take the value of 1, plug it in. Take the value of 2 and plug it in. Take the value of 3 and plug it in. And build out that sequence for yourself. And you will see that that you do have a constant addition. Okay, so this is arithmetic. And I want the sum of the first 17 terms. Not because my upper limit or my upper index is 17, but, you know, because it is a combination of the upper and lower index. If this were, say, 2 and 17, then we wouldn't be adding 17 values, we'd be adding 16 terms or 16 values. So look at your lower index and your upper index and make sure you pay attention to how many terms are actually in that sequence. So if we start counting at 1 and go up to 17, you know, that's what we have, 17 terms. So, let's see. To find the partial sum of, and it's going to be 17 terms, so I can take that n out. It's going to be n divided by 2 times the first term. And I don't know what the first term is. So we're going to go ahead and take the k value of 1 and plug it in. So a sub 1 is going to be 2 times 1 minus 3. Or 2 minus 3 is negative 1, so a sub 1 is equal to negative 1. And my upper limit is 17, so I need my last term because it's n divided by 2 times a sub 1 plus a sub n, the last term in the sequence. So let's get this out of the way. Let's plug in 17. A sub 17 is equal to 2 times 17 minus 3. That's going to be 2 times 10 is 20, 2 times 7 is 14, so we have 34 minus 3, which is 31. So a sub n is 31. So, you know, it's the same kind of question, it's just, you know, how it's presented can change the way that you work out the problem, or at least the way that you think you should work out the problem and make it slightly more difficult. 17 divided by 2 is going to be 8.5, or we can just leave it as 17 over 2. Maybe we'll do that. Here we have negative 1 plus 31, which is going to be 30. And when you start doing arithmetic with fractions, if some of your factors or terms are fractions and other ones are whole numbers, you want to really just let everything look like a fraction so you can see how it lines up properly. And when you multiply fractions, you do go straight across. However, if you notice that some stuff will cancel, factors, if you notice that some factors will cancel, then you might want to go ahead and reduce those fractions a little bit. And we're going to cancel across this multiplication sign. 30 divided by 2 is going to cancel out and give you 15 over 1, and 17 times 15 is equal to, where am I at? There we go. 255. I'm Mr. True. Bam! Go do your homework.